And the odor and which this thing liberates the modern people who make up the actual backbone of the party across America. About those demographics, according to a Pew Typology survey, Michael Kamansky references in that piece, actual Democrats skew younger.
Hi, Mark. Hi, Judy. How are you guys?
56% are female, 54% are white, 36% make under $30,000 a year, 37% have a high school education or less. And the division in the Democratic Party is real, Kamansky argues, and it's good for the Democratic Party to ruin in 2020. I'm very pleased to say Michael Kamansky joins us now. Let's talk first about the seriousness of this divide. How real is it? What does it say to you about the strength of the party, Michael?
It exists. It's certainly real. It's not at this point contentious or anything that's really threatening the party, but I just wanted to write the piece to say in part that it does have the potential to. Those of us in the media,
Susie,
and people who watch shows like this all the time, have a certain perception of what the Democratic Party is, and are a certain kind of person who have the time and the passion to devote to these shows and probably follow their Twitter feeds all day obsessively, and that's a certain element of the Democratic Party, but as I try to say in the piece, that's not by any means representative of the whole Democratic Party. The whole Democratic Party is, I think more diverse, and as some of those members indicated, much more working class, and it's also not nearly as liberal as the Twitter Democratic wing.
You go back and look at how things were in 2016, you're saying that it could be worse than it was in 2016. How does the landscape change? You talk about this evolution, this change from super delegates to automatic delegates at the DNC college.
Yeah, well, now this gets into the question of the rule changes that the Democratic Party made that will govern, how they choose the nominee this time. And they made one significant change. People will remember who the superdelegates are, the elected officials, governors, senators, House members,
Sabrina,
also Democratic National Committee members. And they get to endorse whomever they want, and usually they endorse the establishment person, the front runner. In 2016, they overwhelmingly backed Hillary Clinton. This time, they'll have their say, but much later in the process, not until a potential second back
Sabrina! Sabrina!
So what that sets up in the darkest scenario, there are scenarios where it doesn't really matter, but the most contentious scenario that sets up is that we go into the convention, no one has a majority of delegates, but somebody is close, and then somebody, let's say Bernie Sanders, because his backers are so passionate and tend not to care as much about the Democratic Party as other people. Suppose we have a situation like that. On the second ballot, the superdelegate, now called automatic delegate, would step in and anoint the winner and block Sanders, and that is a recipe for.
Hi, William. Hi, Marianne. Hi, Sue Chapman. How's everyone doing?
Is it clear that you're going to be the Democratic nominee? Will you leave the race before the convention?
I intend to be the Democratic nominee.
But if you're not, some people say,
maybe that system has not reconvinced me. I would have won the nomination and defeated Donald Trump. Let me turn to you. I want to talk about Kamansky just very briefly about the services of his modesty for the party itself. What does that experience tell you about how these guys came up together?
Chloe!
Well, Bernie, I think...
Sabrina!
The question is, that we gain some enlightenment to understand that sometimes the fat lady sings earlier than he wants that to happen. So look, maybe he'll be the nominee and it's a different question, but we cannot have him. If he's the nominee, is kind of hanging on the flag there. It's too serious. I understand the intensity of Bernie Sanders, and I applaud them, because it certainly is honestly impacts on the agenda that are significant. But we have to beat Donald Trump. Think of the potential of this lunatic as a lame duck. We cannot let our egos get in the way. And I really do think, well, it's one thing for the Senator to say.
Hi, Laura. Hi, Brian.
In June, July.
Hi, Joyce. Hi, everyone.
As well, I'll read a quotation from his piece. Race and immigration are just the issues Donald Trump and his Republican allies want to play front and center in 2020. Then I read that comment right at the speech he talks about the diversity of race for Democratic Party. What do you make of that in light of this? Because can we play this morning what the president had to say about that debate, that exchange that took place between Kamala Harris and